Laudetur Jesus Christus and praise be Jesus Christ. You're listening to Vatican Radio's live broadcast of the weekly Sunday noon Angelus, led by Pope Francis, who will be appearing here in St. Peter's Square in just a moment. There's a large crowd of faithful in St. Peter's on this beautiful late October morning. Earlier on Sunday, the Holy Father presided at the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass in St. Peter's Basilica for the 30th Sunday of Ordinary Time. The Solemn Liturgy also marked the formal conclusion of the General Assembly of the Synod of Bishops, the Synod on Synodality, which was celebrating its second session this year, after the first session in 2023. As we go to air this morning, I would like to welcome all of you listening around the world, including those listening in on EWTN TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Catholic TV, and Luminous Radio India. The Gospel at Mass this morning for the Latin Rite was the Gospel of the Healing of Bartimaeus, a man who was blind. And our Holy Father is expected to reflect on the Gospel passage, as he usually does in his remarks prior to the recitation of the Angelus. As most of our listeners are probably aware, the work of the General Assembly of the Synod concluded last night with the vote on the so-called final document. Our Holy Father Pope Francis accepted the work of the Synod and expressed his desire that it be published immediately. It has thus far only been published in Italian. We do expect translations to appear in coming days into the various world languages. In his remarks yesterday, Pope Francis indicated that in a break with tradition, he will not be producing an apostolic exhortation based on this final document, instead wanting the words of the Synod of Fathers and the other participants in the Synod to stand for themselves as the conclusion of this phase of the synodal process, which will continue through the phase of implementation. The Holy Father, as you can hear from the applause, has appeared at the window overlooking St. Peter's Square and will now begin his address.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buona domenica.
Dear brothers and sisters, happy Sunday. Today, the Gospel of the Liturgy tells us about Jesus who cures a man from blindness. The man's name is Bartimaeus, but the crowd in the street ignore him. He's a poor beggar. Those people do not have eyes for this man. No caring gaze. No feeling of compassion. Bartimaeus does not see either, but he hears and he makes himself heard. He shouts, he cries out loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus, however, hears and sees him. He places himself at his disposal and asks, "What do you want me to do for you?" This question before a blind person seems to be a provocation. Instead, it is a test. Jesus is asking Bartimaeus who he is truly looking for and why. For you, who is the son of David? This is how the Lord begins to open the blind man's eyes. Let us consider three aspects of this encounter, which becomes a dialogue: the cry, the faith, and the journey. The cry of Bartimaeus, the faith of Bartimaeus, and the journey. First of all, the cry of Bartimaeus, which is not only a request for help, it is an affirmation of the self. The blind man is saying, I exist, look at me. I do not see you, Jesus. Do you see me? Yes, Jesus sees the beggar, and he listens to him with the ears of the body and those of the heart. Let us consider first, you have the cry of the blind man. The second point is the faith. And Jesus says, go your way, your faith has made you well. Bartimaeus sees because he believes. Christ is the light of his eyes. The Lord observes how Bartimaeus looks at him in the darkness of his life, poor and blind. How do we look at those who are begging? Do we look at them as Jesus does? They are capable of understanding his demands, his cry for help. Look in the eye, when you give an alms, look in the eyes of the one who's asking for you. Finally, the journey. Bartimaeus, healed, followed him along the way. But each one of us are Bartimaeus. We should look within ourselves. Do we follow Jesus? When you draw near to a poor person, Jesus is close in that poor person. Please, let there not be any confusion. Alms is not beneficence. The grace of almsgiving is seen with the eyes of Jesus. Let's pray together to Mary, the dawn of salvation, that she may guard our path in the light of Christ. The Angelus.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tu.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut digni efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che angelo annunciante, Christi Fili tu, incarnazione coniovium, per passionem eius ad crucem, a resurrectionis gloriam perducamo. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luce a teis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
And the Pope gives his blessing.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
And typically at the conclusion of the Angelus, the Holy Father makes a number of appeals. Today we have concluded the Synod of Bishops. Let us pray that all that we have done in this month might go forward for the good of the Church. On October 22nd, we'll celebrate the 50th anniversary of the Commission for Religious Relations with Judaism. It's also the 60th anniversary of the Conciliar Declaration Nostra Aetate on interreligious dialogue.
Domani si aprirà a Ginevra un'importante conferenza internazionale della Croce Rossa e della Mezzaluna.
Tomorrow is an international conference of the Red Cross and the Red Crescent in Geneva for the 70th anniversary of the conventions. And he calls for respect for the dignity of all human persons.
Del diritto internazionale umanitario.
And he calls for respect for international humanitarian rights.
Nella guerra, in qualche parte, si distruggono gli ospedali e le scuole.
And he denounces the destruction of schools and hospitals in areas of conflict and war.
Nello stato messicano del Chiapas, che piange il sacerdote.
He also prays for Father Marcelo Perez, who was assassinated last Sunday in Mexico. He also expresses his closeness to the people of the Philippines, who have been struck by a very strong cyclone. He also greets Romans and pilgrims, and especially the confraternity of Señor de los Milagros, especially honored by Peruvians in Rome here, and they have a large presence here with a procession that they will undertake later this morning. As he also salutes other groups from Italy and around the world, and especially groups from Italy.
E la Confederazione dei Poveri Cavalieri di San Fernando di Chiaravalle. E per favore continuiamo a pregare per la pace.
And please let's continue to pray for peace, especially in Ukraine, Palestine, Israel, Lebanon.
Perché si ponga fine all'escalation e si metta al primo posto il rispetto della vita umana che è sacra.
He calls in the first place for respect for human dignity. The first victims there are the civilian populations. There are too many innocent victims. And calls especially children, too many children who have been killed and wounded by war. Let's pray for peace, he says. And I wish a happy Sunday to all of you. And please, don't forget to pray for me. Enjoy your lunch, and we'll see you soon. Arrivederci. And with those final remarks, the Holy Father offers a wave to the crowds who are gathered here in St. Peter's Square. And that will mark the end of the weekly recitation of the Angelus as the Pope retires to the Apostolic Palace. And that marks the end, too, of our broadcast. I would like to thank once again all of our partner stations, including EWTN-TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Shalom World TV, Catholic TV, and Luminous Radio India. Once again, my name is Christopher Wells. It's been a great pleasure to be with you this morning for the Pope's Angelus. I'm reminded that you can find news about the Mass this morning, about today's Angelus, and other Vatican and world news on our Vatican News web portal at www.vaticannews.va, as well as on our Facebook, Instagram, and X accounts. And we close, as always, praise be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.